Congratulations, Polly. I love
to view next.
And we have our Nyakenywa here. Oh, we are going to celebrate soon.
What can I say about Pauline? Congratulations, my friend. I have known Pauline for a very, very long time when she came to Nottingham. She has been in my house when my little girl Hannah was a baby, and now she's a big girl. We have gone through so much. If I start talking here, it will be like a big book of full of pages. And during now the profession, where we exchange each other from the shift, and at one time she'll be even calling me, oh, I have nobody to take me out from here. I cannot sleep at work. You have to come. You have to come and take me off. I've got nobody to take me off. Congratulations, Pauline. You have done us so proud. Me, I'm as Nyakenywa, a mother of children. I've been to school with children of my children's age. I've also done it. I'm encouraging every Nyakenywa there to go to school. I've done it. Next month or so, maybe my graduation ceremony like this, we will put it in the group, and you'll be also all of you welcome. So, Pauline, keep up your hard work and congratulations.
Yeah, let's welcome where Kiswahili started. Yes. Tanzania.
Pauline, all I can say to you is big congratulations. You did well.
So you can see is that we have a big team. We got a few more who are coming in, shying off to come to the front team.
Like you all know me, many of you know me here in Nottingham. My name is Timothy Dungu. Pauline is my friend for many years. When she was a student, I met her somewhere because she disappeared. Then it happened. I met her somewhere in Aspreden. Oh, where have you been, Pauline? Oh, I've been visiting. So she told me what she had been doing. I said to her, Pauline, come on, keep going. You can do it. You know what? Congratulations and well done. Eh?
Yeah.
You are a good example to many of us. Adults, I use one word, adults. You are an adult runner. All these guys, you can do it, even you guys who feel like you can do it. Nothing is difficult. If we have done it, you can do it. Good luck, and I wish you all the best in your career.
This is my husband. I don't have much to say other than congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you so
much. We cover her and her family with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Father, we honor you, Jehovah God. Mighty God, even her business, Jehovah God, it will flourish, Jehovah God, that it will be a benefit even to many people, mighty God. We bless you for being a blessing even in our community. She has been a role model in our community, Jehovah God. May you continue to bless her. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and believe. And everybody say,
Amen.
Give her my hand clap.
Congrats. Let's clap for this girl. I said it's important we listen because for those who are in schools, and I'm talking here now as an academic. Yes, in medicine, you will do a PhD in medicine, okay?
Say amen.
So I'll give this to you, but I needed us to recognize you before you give your speech to your mother, because I know you've been a pillar to her. Her struggles are your struggles. you have suffered equally as much as she suffered. So here to you, my baby girl. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Bridget and I'm 11 years old. I'm so proud of my mom for graduating as a nurse. While at DeMonte University, my mom worked so hard that at times we couldn't see her for 2 days, as she used to leave home very early and come back late. My mom would stay at the library until late, sometimes past 2 a.m., since the library was open 24 hours. My mom has worked so hard as a nurse during the global pandemic, looking after ill patients at the hospital, doing 12-hour shifts. My mom would come home so tired, but I was happy to welcome her with a hot cup of tea. I appreciate Auntie Perry, who would come to our house and take care of us whilst my mom was working. My aunt would cook delicious Kenyan food for dinner, especially chapatis. She has taught me how to cook some of these dishes. Thank you, Auntie Perry.
Thank you, too.
I truly believe that my mom has worked so hard looking after ill patients, giving them medication and treating them for 12 hours all the time. Congratulations, Mom. You've done so well. Myself and Braden are so proud of you. You'll forever be our role model. I thank God that my mom has made it all the way here, despite all the challenges that came along. God bless you, Mom. A big thank you to all of you coming to celebrate with us. Please help me give my mom a big round of applause.
Wasn't that beautiful, guys? Let's give her a big, big applause. Thank you, Bridget, and thank you for those words.
Patients. At one point, you were scared, but I encouraged you. Your sacrifices have brought these good results. As if that wasn't enough, you have recently again gone ahead and managed to register a care agency, and you told me you want to be your own boss. Again, congratulations for that milestone. Ladies and gentlemen, as I stand here, I'm looking at Denbridge director. Please let us stand with her, continue supporting her. I am now praying for you to get those contracts and to continue enjoying the fruits of your hard work. Last but not the least, as I wind up or conclude, there's something I want to say about Pauline. From day one, she proved to be a warrior, a go-getter who does not believe in defeat. She has always challenged me, encouraging me when things don't work out, not to give up, keep trying. She's not the kind of person to give up easily or feeling sorry for herself. Her motto is, if plan A doesn't work, go for plan B. I mean, there is always a solution to each and every situation. No matter how long it takes, patience pays. She couldn't even let mom get to the hospital to deliver her. She was determined to come out and face the world. When mom brought her home, I couldn't get my eyes off her, playing with her chubby cheeks. She has always been very confident, not someone to be pushed about. Will always speak her mind and stand for herself. Put you straight and say as it is. No sugarcoating. She doesn't know how to pretend or to fake it. A day came when she was enrolled to a primary school and she proved herself excelling well academically, passing with flying colors. Not forgetting sports. She was a good footballer and everyone knew that she was one of the best team players. All I could hear was "Kigotho, Kigotho," as we cheered her up, scoring the goals. Let us stand and raise our glasses to our dear sister, Pauline. Pauline, cheers.
Greetings. Good afternoon, Braden. How are you guys? I hope that you're all keeping well. I know that today is the day when you're holding a party for Mambi to celebrate her success. And because of that reason, I would like to take this opportunity to balance work, school, and family. And may God's blessings and favor follow you in all the days of your life. May this degree that you have attained open more doors and more doors of success in your life. As for our dearest elder sister, Perry, we hold you so dear in our hearts. I know that you may not know this, but the support that you've given to all of us, the prayers that you normally post in our family WhatsApp group, touches our hearts. Just know that you are our mentor, and you are our role model. And we look up at you every day to shape our lives. God bless you for that. And thank you so, so much for that. As for Bridget and Braden, our niece, our nephew, we love you too. We love you so much. And you're such a blessing in our lives. Bridget and Braden, thank you so much in a special way for giving mommy an easy time to study, and God bless you for that. Just know that mom has set a pace, and I hope that you're going to follow her path so that you can also attain your degrees, you can also attain your masters, you can also attain your PhDs, because you have all that it takes to achieve all that.
foremost, I want to thank God for making this possible. To thank God for good health, to thank God to get it through the pandemic, and to thank God that we planned it, but He made it possible. So, thank you. Second, I want to thank you all for honoring my invitation. I invited many, but some didn't turn up. Some didn't turn up with apology, and you all turned up. Thank you so much. I can see I'm loved, and I'm appreciated. For you to leave all your shifts, to leave all you, what you were doing, you spared this day, and you say, this is Pauline's day. I don't take that for granted. So thank you so much for coming. Because if Jumia would have cooked and no one was there to eat, so what could we have done with the food? You don't throw away at home, but you came. Thank you so much. So it has been a journey to get to where I am today. Just like my lovely Judy said, it started in 2013. That's when I joined University of Derby to do my diploma for higher education, because I didn't do my GCSEs here, so I had to do an access course for me to get through the university. So that's why I joined the university to do a diploma, which enabled me to secure a place at the De Montfort University in Leicester. So you might think, why did it take so long? Just like Judy had mentioned, that was 2013, I was at Derby. Then in 2014, my son was born, Brendan. So I had two diplomas, the academic diploma and the other one. So after that, it was so hectic to travel to Leicester. So you can imagine leaving a 4-month-old baby to go to Leicester. So it was impossible. I couldn't do it. It was far too much. And you know, as African mothers, we breastfeed. So you can imagine leaving the house at 7 o'clock in the morning. I used to catch the 7:55 train from Nottingham. And then I'll be back home, maybe after 6. So you can imagine all those hours. Mazue ilikuwa inatereduka, inatoka kwa njia. Then I say, milk, yeah, yes. So I thought, oh well, no. It's too much for me, it's too much for my son. Then I took a break. To start with, I deferred for 1 year. So thinking, okay, I'll go back after 1 year. He'll be 1 year by then, I'll manage. So when I deferred, I decided, oh well, you know who you are when you have a baby, you can't work, you've got no childcare. The childcare is too expensive to even work. Meaning, you'll be working for childcare. You work, then come and pay childcare. So then I thought, oh well, take a break, go to Kenya. That's how I ended up in Kenya. So before I continue, let me talk a little bit how I ended up here back. So I went to pack my things, my children. So we went to Kenya, stayed there. Oh, it's a big change coming from UK to Kenya. So at first, things there are very slow. You go to a bank and the queue is up to outside. So you're thinking, oh no, am I gonna queue this? In UK, you walk into Barclays, just one person in front of you, and you're done. So a lot of things, transport as well. If you're not driving in Kenya, it's very difficult. So imagine, just imagine myself as I, we call it V8. I'm a V8, you know V8, that car, yeah? Big machine, yeah? Size, yeah, so imagine me in a matatu. So I occupy 2 seats. So it's impossible, so you have to be driving. Yeah, because to be able to go from one point A to B, because that's what you are used here. So anyway, it was a good experience, I would say. But I managed. By the time I would get used to it, I would say it was near 1 year. And then that time was my time to come back, because I had deferred for 1 year. Then I was like, okay, things are falling into place here. Do I really want to go back? I said, no. So I contacted the university. I said, oh, well, I'm still not ready. So I deferred for another 1 year. So this 1 year, it was beautiful. Things started falling into place. I ventured into business. I'm a business-minded person. And I find myself, I met people who introduced me to things and all. And I found myself doing supplies. I used to supply food and stuff, the beans to prisons in Kenya. So that went down very well. And then again, when things are getting very, very beautiful, it was my time again to come back. And that's where I took almost 2 weeks to make a decision, because it wasn't bad. You know, in Kenya, when you have, and that time I have a house help, so I'm able to move around. So childcare was not stress for me. I had a car, so life was good. So I was like, okay, well, so I had to sit down and think. I sat down with my parents, my family, my sisters, the one who talked, she's Veronica, she's the one who follows me. She's a finance manager at Akoseli College in Thika. So we sat down and start drawing, yeah, what are the benefits, advantages, this and this and that. By that time, you know, the nursing was being funded. So I had nothing to pay, no fees to pay. In fact, I was getting paid to go to school. So from there, and my dad and my mom, so they advised, okay, you've got nothing to lose. Leave the business, we'll take care of it. You go back to UK, go pursue your career. Once you have it here, that was my mom, it will never leave here. You can come back with it. And because it's being paid for, you've got nothing to lose. And that's when I packed again with my children and came back to UK in 2016 and joined the Montfort University to pursue my nursing degree. And that's why. So we finished in 2019. We were to graduate in 2020, but because of the COVID, we couldn't graduate in July 2020, postponed until January, until now, until Wednesday this week. So it has been a journey. So I want to appreciate the family and friends who have been there for me, because going to school as a mature student is not easy. And especially when you have young children, you have responsibilities, you have bills to pay, you have rent to pay, you have other things, you have family back home whom I need, 1, 2, 3. So it wasn't easy, but I had my family. First, I would have appreciated my nanny from Romania. Most of you know her, Irina. She couldn't be here because of COVID. She was isolating, very unfortunate. I would have loved her to be here. We celebrate together. She joined me in 2016, December. and just left me or left our family this January. She has secured herself a job at Boots. So I did appreciate her because she looked after my children. She gave herself, making sure that they have gone to school, they have eaten. She learned how to cook ugali. She learned how to cook mokimo. Everything. She would just ask me, what am I cooking today, Pauline? And I would say, cook mokimo, and she would do it. She became more like a family. So I did appreciate her. So my sister here, Aunt Perry, she has been there as well. She's been with them when I've gone to placement in Leicester, because my placements were in Leicester because I was a September start. But if I was January start, I would have had my placements in Nottingham. So it wasn't easy leaving home very early, then coming back home. But she was there to make sure that everything is going on well. Let's appreciate Auntie Perry. Stand up, please. The other person I want to appreciate who is here with us, the Oga family. You were told I'm the Oga family. I'm an Igbo. Igbo. Those who didn't know, I want to appreciate Braden's dad. Please stand up. That's Braden's dad, who has also supported me very, very much. Picking them from school, Bridget and Braden, dropping them, take them to activities when I wasn't available, he was there. Let's appreciate him. Thank you. So they always say, even if things don't work well between you, remain friends. So we are very good friends. Very, very good friends. So I respect him and I love him as Braden's dad. The other person I would like to appreciate or friends is Pauline. Mama John also, she has been there. Stand up, please. Let's appreciate you. I did appreciate you. Another person is Annette, my Ugandan friend. Just appreciate Annette as well. I was with Annette at University of Derby. We did our diploma together. Then she ventured into pharmacy. I ventured into nursing. So she's a pharmacist. Thank you for your support. And also, if I didn't mention any other friend who would have been involved in any way during my child care challenges, Aunt Violet, I know you've been there. Thank you. I really appreciate you. Thank you so much. Academically, I want to appreciate my good friend, the one I've just mentioned, Dr. Violet. She has been there. She's been my mentor. She has guided me. She has advised me. She has helped me. You mention it. Anything to do with academics, she was there. I remember when we were given our research assignment. For those who have done research, you know the words that come with research. Sometimes they are very scary. You sit in that lecture room, and the lecturer is saying phenomenology, hypothesis, methodology, and you're like, what is that? Yeah, quantitative analysis, critical analysis. She made me understand all that, and I got a distinction because of her. Let's appreciate her for doing that. So before I continue, can I please have a song? The song that kept me going, I'm Just a Woman. Every time I would feel low, every time I would feel, oh dear, this is hard. you know, that song used to give me the strength to carry on. You got to do what you got to do. DJ, please. Scary because I didn't know what could happen. Everybody was scary, but we carried on. At one time, I would wake up and think, oh, God, I'm going again. What will happen? I was worried of myself, I was worried of my children. The thought of what if, it made me scary. But just like when you join the army, when you're being told you're going to Cambodia, you're going to Afghanistan, you're going to Iraq, you can't say no. You don't have a choice, you have to go. So it's the same with nursing. if you join the profession, COVID came, we had to fight it. I saw it all in ICU, and it was emotional. So from there, I diverted, keeping in mind as a new qualified, I didn't even get my supernumerary period because there was no time to. When you qualify as a nurse, you get for 6 weeks. 6 weeks in ICU as a supernumerary, where you'll be inducted of how things work on that ward. So myself, I didn't get off that. I only got the whole of February because March came and then it's COVID. So there's nobody to mentor you. They're fighting the pandemic. So I had to work, get on with it. Afterwards, June, July, I decided no, this is not for me. And the good thing with nursing, it's diverse. You can diverse, you can move ward, you can go to different specialties, you can choose the specialty that you want. So I said, no, critical care is not for me. I want to be speaking to my patient. I want to have conversation to my patient. I don't want to sit here on a chair with a patient. There are 12 hours, I'm not talking to them. And also knowing that their life is on your hands. It's not easy. You have to act, you have to be quick, you have to be keen. It's intense. So I moved on to oncology. I like cancer. I like to specialize. I would like to specialize with cancer. That's why I moved to City Hospital on oncology ward. And it was good there. I went there, it was okay. That time the COVID had slowed down. And it's from there I resigned after working there for almost a year and decided to venture into business. So I did not leave my nursing career. I'm still working as a nurse on part-time basis while I facilitate my business. My company is Dembridge Care Limited. We are recruiting nurses. We are getting there now, slowly but sure. It's not going bad. So far I've joined REED, so far I've joined Geometric Resorts, GRI we call it. That's the main supply company in the UK. So all agencies are working through GRI to be able to supply stuff to care homes, hospitals and everything. And so I've joined GRI now, and we can supply nurses to Nottingham Trust University. So all the nurses, you can support me, you can come and join me. List to finish off. All I would like to say, especially give a little advice to the young ones, the youth, or even the adults who are here. Going back to school is the best ever thing that I did. I learned a lot, not even academically, but also so many things in life. When you choose your career, choose it wisely. Choose a career that you know after completing your degree, you get a job. Whatever you have studied will secure you a job. Choose it wisely. You're not going to tarmac looking for a job. And I would advise any career in healthcare, you can never go wrong. Nursing is a career where you get a job even before you qualify. I got my job in January 2019 and I qualified September 2019. So I secured myself a job while still at the university. So they were just waiting for my PIN for me to start. So they kept calling me, has your PIN come, has your PIN come? Yes, it's here. When do you want to start? Anything healthcare, social work, radiologist, physiotherapist, you name it. You can never go wrong. Not saying that the other courses are not important, they are. It all depends with where you are, but choose wisely. Don't waste 3 years doing a course that will not benefit you when you finish. then you have to go back again to university. I've seen so many people who have done something like psychology. So they come out, they finish psychology. They can't secure a job anywhere. So they have to go back again, do something else for them to get a job. So when you choose your career, choose it wisely. So thank you very much for coming. Let us celebrate. Thank you for my friends, all of you who have come from far, Chesterfield, my friends from Bedford, Derby. Not to forget Richie. Let's appreciate Richie and his friend. They have come all the way from Calais. Not the France Calais, the Calais that borders Scotland. For him to go to Squanda would be 10 minutes to the border. So that is Richie. Let's appreciate him. He's Patrick's brother. Greetings, immediate uncle. And that's all I have to say. Thank you for coming. I'm happy. I'm humbled. It's unfortunate my family could not be here. There was a lot of delays with the visit visas. So they were delayed. When I called the embassy to ask, they said there was a delay. And there were no priority visas when we applied for the visa. So we had to do the normal one. So the decision has not been made until now. And they are coming for my graduation. So we don't know what will happen. So thank you so much for being here. Even though they are there, at least I have a family, and you are my family. Thank you for coming. Thank you so much.
That is exactly what she did with her assessment, that she ensured that she asked everyone. We were told A, ask. B, we were told what? But not a me boy.
Believe.
Believe, yeah. We can believe that Pauline is going to feed us. So, I'm very sure you can see what he is doing. Bridget and your brother, go that side so that we help Pauline and get a photo. Are you believing that the cake is going to come up to where you are? Yeah. Because we are using a B.
Yeah.
What were we told about a C?
I
am very sure you can see how it is confidence, and we are going to use confidence. You can see how Pauline is cutting it, no joke. So, what can we tell Pauline today? That you, let's see, what is it? Is it a sponge cake, a chocolate cake? What is it?
It's a chocolate cake.
Ah, you have had it. We cannot wait. Let's see my son. Kata. You can see it is brown, meaning it is chocolate. It is white. So we have a lot of choices. And when you see these kids happy, it's because the cake is coming along. So well done. What I would say.
shida. Hey, 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 wait. Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out. Hey. Yani, yani siku ya kulimu unajaribu kuharibu siku hivi kabisa. DJ, DJ, stopisha. Wait, 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 wait. Hey, 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 hey. Eh? Haya, tupange line hivi. Hivi, hivi, hivi. Inaitangu waje, wanya nyingi umesoma. Inaitu waje. Oh, sorry. I am so sorry. Okay, let's make this. What's this? This is a column, isn't it? Eh? Okay, let's make a column. Eh, what? Eh. Are we your face team?
Oh, we're making a line.
Your face that way, yeah. Just get steps, yeah. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Move, 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 cha. Are we okay till there? Alright, DJ, again, again. Wait, stop it. Wait, wait. I'm doing it wrong. Stop it. So it's 3, 4. Repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. DJ, what? Now get